It's going to be another fantastic day on the work site, Connor. I can just feel it.
I do too, Kevin. It just feels right.
Here's something else that feels right. Pulling names out of our hats and seeing who's here today. Are you ready?
We're going to do something a little different today.
Different? Can we do that?
Of course we can. When you think about it, every day has been a little bit different. Different snacks, different crafts.
And different Bible studies. You're right, Connor. We've done so many different things.
Which brings me to the different thing we're going to do today. You know how we've been pulling names out of our hard hats?
Yes.
Well, today we're going to put something in our hard hats. We're going to catch some of the things that our friends say.
That sounds great. Let's do it.
Okay, here's what we're going to do. I'm going to ask a question, and if you want to answer it, raise your hand. Then we'll catch your answers in our hard hats. Here's the question. What have you enjoyed most about being at Concrete and Crayons?
That was different and fun. Shall we?
That calls for a big whoop whoop.
Woohoo!
Now we can remember what you said.
And here's something for all of us to remember. Today's bonus verse. But as for you, continue in what you have learned and firmly believed. You know those who taught you. 2 Timothy 3:14.
We've been learning all kinds of things as we've continued building on the love of Jesus.
And we still have more to do. And so do you.
It's going to be a great day.
And here's the song, Forgiveness. Now you're gonna start off by pulling your hand in front of your face and going in a circle, and then do the same thing on the other side. Now verse 1 starts with, there's no way that we can earn it. Bring it in with a fist. There's no way that we deserve it. Another fist right here, bring your hands down. His love, and then push your arms out to the side, is free, so free. How can it be? And then bring your hands together. How can it be? Now here we're going to go, even when our hearts condemn us, greater is the God who's in us. Let's do that again a little bit faster. Even when our hearts condemn us, greater is the God who's in us. Very nice. And now we're going to jump into the chorus. God proves his love for us while we were yet sinners. Bring your arm across. While we were yet sinners, Christ died. Bring your wrists together upon the cross. Then scoop up to bring us with your hands facing you, forgiveness. Do it again. God proves his love for us while we were yet sinners. We were yet sinners. Christ died upon the cross to bring us forgiveness. And now for verse 2. There's no way we can attain it. No other way we can explain it. His love, push out again, is free. So free. How can it be? How can it be? Here we go. We're going to do this part again. Even when our hearts condemn us, greater is the God who's in us. Then we're going to go back into the chorus. God proves his love for us while we were yet sinners. We were yet sinners. Christ died upon the cross to bring us forgiveness. Do it again. God proves his love for us. While we were yet sinners, we were yet sinners. Christ died upon the cross to bring us forgiveness. Now here's the ending part. You're gonna go forgiveness and bring it down. Then the opposite side, forgiveness, bring it down. Then with both hands, forgiveness, bring them down. And then one more time, you're gonna scoop up. And it's gonna say to bring us forgiveness. forgiveness. You're gonna jump into this pose. So it's gonna say, to bring us forgiveness. And now you know the whole song.
Boys and girls, my name is Mr. Ben, and thank you for coming to the last day of Concrete and Cranes, VBS. Today we're going to be reading from Matthew chapter 7, verses 24 to 29. So please open up your Bibles and follow along with me. Everyone then who hears these words of mine and does them will be like a wise man who built his house on the rock. And the rain fell, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat on that house. But it did not fall, because it had been founded on the rock. And everyone who hears these words of mine and does not do them will be like a foolish man who built his house on the sand. And the rain fell, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat against the house, and it fell, and great was the fall of it. And when Jesus finished these sayings, the crowds were astonished at his teaching, for he was teaching them as one who had authority, not as the scribe. So today, boys and girls, we learned about Jesus' story about the wise and the foolish builders. One day, Jesus was speaking to a crowd of people, and he told them a parable, the story of Jesus that he told the people to understand God's kingdom. About two builders, to help them understand why it was so important to listen to words and to do what they said. Jesus began by telling the crowd that everyone who heard the words he spoke and acted on them would be like the wise man who built his house on the rock. The house had a strong foundation, so that when the rains fell, the rivers rose, and the winds blew against it, and the house did not collapse. However, those who heard Jesus' words but did not act on them would be like the foolish man who built his house on the sand. His house did not have a strong foundation, so when the rains fell and the rivers rose and the wind blew against the house, it came crashing down. Jesus' teaching amazed these people who had been listening to him. And Jesus told this parable to help us understand that when we listen and obey him, we will have a strong foundation in whatever happens in our lives. So, what is a parable? Why did Jesus tell a parable about two builders? In Jesus' parable, what happened to the man who built his house on a rock? And in Jesus' parable, what happened to the builder who built his house on a rock? Now, which builder represents someone who obeys Jesus? That's all we have for today, kids. Thank you so much for coming this week. We love you guys so much, and I hope you enjoy your next module.
It had been a hard week for Renzo. His building construction was getting beat bad by Foreman Nehemiah's project. He had been demoted and humiliated in the press.
Extra! Extra! Boy genius of fraud! Poor choices ruined building!
And worst of all, he had lost his prize. A brand new Kids Colossal Bible Club on the 34th floor to help children learn about Jesus. Times were so tough for Renzo that his mum and dad had come to his side. But what he didn't know was that his prayers would soon be answered in the middle of the biggest challenge he had ever faced.
I still don't understand how they built this so fast.
Because they didn't hire a kid to be their architect. Next time I get a grand idea, do me a favor and stop me.
Well...
Zip it, Santiago.
I don't like the looks of that storm.
Lloyd, find some rain gear. It's gonna get wet.
Lloyd, you're always so prepared.
Well, well, well. Look who showed up to lose.
Your team's building has defeated Renzo Tower as the world's tallest building. So, on behalf of Kitten Construction, Inc.
Wait, Mrs. Kuhas.
Yeah.
These blockos. This is Renzo's design. He didn't get the math wrong. Foreman Nehemiah stole our blockos.
Oh, really? Huh? What? Can you prove it?
Yeah. It says Renzo's patented blockos all over them.
Well, no one will care. All anyone will remember is that this is the strongest building ever built by Foreman Nehemiah!
Whoa!
Fellas!
You know, I think you're right, dear. It might rain.
If this wind and rain keeps up, the water will get into the base.
Should I gather two of every animal?
Why didn't you build a firm foundation?
So we could beat Renzo!
Oh, people will remember this building, all right.
Oh, that looks like fun.
Renzo, what's happening?
They skipped the foundation!
No foundation means...
They go bye-bye.
We have to do something!
You can't exactly give them a hand, son.
Not just a hand,
a whole arm! I'm going to the crane! Dad, take a wrench and loosen as many girders as you can!
I'm on it. You really are prepared.
Lefty Lucy. Lefty Lucy.
Hang on, people! Woo-hoo! This is gonna work. It has to work.
President of Kitten Cobra Construction. It is my honor to commemorate the grand opening of Friendship Towers, a revolutionary new concept for city living. Anything you want to add, young man?
Please, build your life on a strong foundation.
Yes, that's the story of Renzo Wright and the greatest truth we can ever learn. Jesus' love is the foundation for the rest of our lives. Oh, and if you're wondering, Renzo got his kids' colossal Bible club to help teach other children to learn about Jesus. So remember, he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion.
Extra, extra! Boy Genius opens Kids' Colossal Bible Club to help children all over the city! Read all about it! Get your paper!
Who needs a name badge?
Thank you, Lloyd. Always so prepared.
Hi, this is a lot day of 5 days class. So this is the last day. So when you just open the big bag, you can see that this brown house shape. And that's the green one. And two white green. And then one gray one. And the two yellow one. And one more. This is the magnet. One more time. So we're gonna make your friend for today. So first one, just grab the green one, it's the roof. So back there, they have a white paper. Take it off. One more. Okay, we're gonna put the top. This way. And we're gonna use the black one. Also, they have a stickers. So we're gonna put here up the white one and put in the bottom. You can do the either way, this way or that way. Either is fine. I'm gonna do top. And this is the window frame. So we're gonna put using the you want to have a glue. You can just stick one. The wicked one is fine. Just using the glue. Okay. And the other side. And the other one, same way. Yellow color. Make sure that's just a window. And you grab the two white fence. Either way, you can use the pen to draw line or you can cut if you want to for the decoration. So it's just your way. I'm gonna do the line. Actually, that is a sticker. You can just like peeling off. Sorry, and just put it down. Or if you want to cut, you can cut. Okay, you can see that. You can see that this way or this way. Any way you want it. This is fine, so you can just the decoration the side of that. After that, grab any portal that you just want to put, like a family one or a friend's, or even you can draw in the any type of paper. So you can just like put in the here. So I choose my son's folder to make sure because he's my lovely son's. So now I just put the pictures here. Sometimes the pictures are smaller, using in the paper, so you can put the colors here and then you just cut down the frames as best sizes. Because sometimes the colors are a little bit smaller than the frame sizes on it. So when you just do it, I'm just using it on other paper on the outside and the inside there's my son's because then my quarter is like a picture so like a little bit smaller than the frame sizes on it. Then you can just apply by the sticker or glue, anything is fine, just please attach it on it. And last step is the another, making it one more time. Just pick up the back paper and put in the top. So if you want to, you can just write down any word about the Jesus or top is fine. My way is like, I just write down Jesus is my foundations. Or you can just write down the Jesus is my love. Anything you want to just write down, you can just write down for decorations. And this is the finals. So thank you for today and have a nice weekend. Bye-bye.
Oh my goodness, boys and girls, it's the last day of VBS, and today is all about building on the foundation for life. In your Bible story today, you learned about the wise and the foolish builders. And the point is that Jesus's love is the foundation for the rest of my life. I hope that your keychains are fully filled up from those memory verses. Our bonus verse for today comes from 2 Timothy chapter 3, verses 14, and it says, "But as for you, continue in what you have learned and firmly believe. You know those who taught you." Boys and girls, this has been so much fun, and I am so happy that you were able to join us. I cannot wait to see y'all this Sunday, hopefully, and I hope you've enjoyed VBS 2020. Bye. Well, Kevin, it looks like our job is almost done.
Almost, but not yet. We have to make sure we've hammered every nail and cleaned up the worksite.
Then it'll be time to move on to the next project.
Connor, you mean there's more?
Yeah, there's always something else. Just think of all you can do now. You've learned so many things that you can take with you and use. You can even teach what you've learned to others.
That makes me feel better. I was wondering what was next. I didn't have anything else to pull out of my hat.
Well, put your hard hat back on, Kevin, because there's still a lot to do.
Okay, I'm ready. Let's build on the foundation for life we learned about.
Jesus' love is the foundation for the rest of my life.
And mine.
And yours.
What's going on, boys and girls? So VBS is over and we had a lot of fun putting together this Minecraft set for you guys so that you guys can have a more enjoyable and fun experience for VBS. But now that we're finished,
I think we gotta just blow this thing up.
Oh, right? You are absolutely right, Pastor Daniel. We are gonna blow up everything. And you can see that Pastor Daniel's already getting started. He's so excited. We hope you guys are excited for this too, because we're gonna blow up everything.
I mean, TNT is my favorite Minecraft block. I mean, how could you not like it? Anything that goes bang like this? Oh, I'm getting excited. Oh, I think we need more TNT.
More TNT?
More.
You can never have too much.
Wait, is this like safe? It's fine.
Yeah, it should be fine. Right.
It's fine.
Yeah, you're right. You know, what could possibly go wrong?
I don't think anything could like go wrong, right? I mean, so much. I think it's like, as long as like we keep some distance, right?
Yeah, you know, just like just a couple feet, right?
I'm gonna blow this one out.
I'm gonna do this one.
I just want to see like how powerful it is, you know? Okay.
All right.
I'm gonna light it and then I'm gonna run. Okay.
Oh yes.
Oh fire.
Put the fire.
Oh wait, are you gonna blow something up?
Yeah. Oh no, we gotta put more TNT.
Oh dude, more?
More TNT.
Oh I like it. I'm going TNT crazy. Oh so
more.
Much. So much. By the way, kids, you probably shouldn't try this at home. But don't worry, we're like super experienced.
Always be careful with your explosives, children.
That's good advice, Chris. It's really good advice. Is that enough?
More. We need more.
Alright. More. 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 Oh, I'm just gonna make a TNT tower.
Oh, I like the way you think, Pastor Daniel.
Oh, look at it. Oh, so glorious. I wonder how high I can make this.
So much TNT. So much explosives. So much danger.
Danger. Yeah, I think that's like,
You think that's enough?
That is
a lie. Are we ready to lie to Pastor Daniel?
Oh my gosh, yeah.
Would you like to do the honors?
I'm gonna light from here.
I think we need a countdown for all of this.
Oh, this is gonna be so glorious! Okay.
Alright, Pastor Daniel.
Okay.
Where are you, Pastor Daniel?
I'm at the top of the tower.
You're at the top of the tower?
I'm gonna light it from here, and it's gonna all go bye-bye.
Okay, Pastor Daniel. On the count of three?
Count of three.
One.
One.
Two.
I'm ready.
And.
Oh, I did it.
No, no!
Here we go. Yes.
Woohoo!
Oh, that's a big.
It's all gone. Everything's gone.
I hate to point it out, Chris, but there's like a little bit left over.
Oh, a little bit left over?
Maybe you could we need to make sure it's all gone. Maybe.
Yeah, maybe, yeah. Just a huge chunk.
I hope.
We're gonna destroy the remainder of this.
Oh, it's all has to go. Everything has to go.
Just a side note, kids. Me and Pastor Daniel do not condone any of this.
Yeah, I don't recommend this. You know, if you work hard to build something in Minecraft, you should probably, like, save it. But, you know, I mean, also explosions. Explosions.
We also encourage you guys not to do any of this in real life.
Yeah, that's not a good idea.
Need more. But what we do encourage, kids, is if you do enjoy building stuff, Minecraft is a great game.
Yeah, it can be a lot of fun.
Oh, Pastor Daniel, where'd you go?
Alright, magic trick.
We need to come back.
Oh, okay, bam! Look, I did it. Oh, wait. Chris.
Yes?
Right. Okay. Look at me.
Yeah?
Alright, you wanna see a magic trick?
Yeah.
Wanna see a magic trick?
Sure.
Okay. Look deep into my eyes.
Okay. Ready? Deep into your eyes.
Ready?
Yeah.
Ready? Bam!
Ooh!
Oh, wait, ready?
Yeah?
I'm ready to see it. Bam!
Pastor Daniel, the kids can see everything that's happening.
TNT! Yeah, TNT! Woo! I think we might have gone a little overboard.
Just a little bit?
Yeah.
Pastor Daniel, I think that we haven't done enough.
Oh, okay. I hope.
We have to make sure that nothing's left.
I agree. Yeah. It seems like maybe it's a lot. I think this is a lot. It's fine. This was fine. Uh-oh. I gotta get this too.
Boys and girls, throughout the course of this VBS, if you developed an interest in construction engineering, we highly encourage you guys to seek out people who can teach you more about this stuff and working with cool and awesome tools.
Oh, that's a really good idea, Chris. Got it. y'all didn't see anything.
Pastor Daniel, are you struggling over there?
There's no, like, right way to do this, you know? I'm gonna go pretty far away. This seems dangerous.
This is actually very dangerous, actually.
I'm gonna hang out in this tree.
All right.
Yeah. Okay.
Are we ready?
Are we ready? I mean, hey.
All right.
Oh,
here we go.
Do it.
Do we need a countdown?
Oh yeah. Okay. Are you ready? All right. Three. Two. One and a half? One and a quarter? Okay, one. Do it.
Here we go.
Oh, explosions.
Woohoo!
Oh.
Woohoo!
Wow.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Nothing left.
Boys and girls, I think it's safe to say VBS is officially over.
All right. Boys and girls, thank you so much for joining us for VBS, and we thank you so much for joining us for our post-VBS construction site explosion and demolition.
Yeah.
Pastor Dan, do you have any closing remarks that you'd like to give to the kids?
Hey, I just want to tell you guys that we miss you so much. We really hope that you guys had lots of fun with us for VBS, and I can't wait till I get to see you all again. Also, explosions.
All right, boys and girls, take care.
Bye. Hey, boys and girls, I am so excited that you've been able to spend this time with us and learn about what it means to build our life on the foundation of Jesus. For many of you, I know that you maybe come to church all the time, but for some of you, you may be thinking that you want to commit your life to building on the foundation of Jesus. You know, the gospel is a word that means the good news, and it's a message about Christ, the kingdom of God, and salvation. So, boys and girls, I want to explain to you there are four things that you should remember. Number one is that God rules. You know, the Bible tells us that God created everything, including you and me, and that He's in charge of everything. You know, but it also says that we sinned. You know, since the time of Adam and Eve, everyone has chosen to disobey God. The Bible calls this sin because God is holy. God can't be around sin. You know, sin actually separates us from God. And it deserves God's punishment, which is death. But boys and girls, God provided. God sent His Son Jesus, the perfect solution to our sin problem, to rescue us from the punishment that we deserve. It's something we as sinners could never earn on our own. Jesus alone saves us. You know, the last point is that Jesus gives. Jesus lived a perfect life. He died on the cross for our sins, and He rose again. Because Jesus gave up His life for us, we can be entirely welcomed into God's family for an eternity. So if you want today to join this family of Christians, of believers who trust in God, I would like to invite you now. You know, we respond to God's grace. We respond by the things that we know. And one of the ways we respond is by understanding the ABCs of salvation. A stands for admit. We need to admit to God that we're sinners. You know, the first people that God created chose to sin and disobey God. You can tell God that you messed up and that you're sorry for doing your own thing and turning away from Him through your thoughts and your words and your actions. Repent means to turn away from your sin, but it doesn't just mean to turn away from doing bad things to doing good things. To turn away from your sin and even your own good works and turn to Jesus and trusting only in Him to save you. That's what it means to repent. B is for believe. We can believe that Jesus is God's Son and we receive God's gift of forgiveness from sin. You must believe that only Jesus can save you, and you can't save yourself. You can't save yourself by praying or by going to church or by reading your Bible. Your faith and your trust is only in Jesus and what He did through His life, death, and resurrection. And finally, we confess. We confess our faith in Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord. We tell God and tell others what we believe. If Jesus is your Savior, you're trusting only in Him to save you. You know, Jesus is also Lord, which means He is in charge. You can start following Him and doing what it says in the Bible, You are born again to a new life, and you can look forward to being with God forever. So boys and girls, if you want to commit your life to Jesus and the foundation of his love, and you want Christ to be the king of your heart, boys and girls, I would like to invite you to pray with me now. You can simply repeat after me. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, I know that I am a sinner. I know that sin separates me from your love. Jesus, I ask that you forgive me of my sins. I believe that you are God, that you came to earth and lived a perfect life without sin. Jesus, I want you to be the king of my life. Jesus, please send your Holy Spirit to lead me and guide me. Jesus, thank you for welcoming me into your family. I love you. I praise you. I worship you. In Jesus' name, amen. Boys and girls, if you said that prayer with me right now, I am so incredibly proud of you. I am absolutely here for you. If you have any questions or concerns, you can reach out to me. My email is in the description box. I'd love to talk to you, encourage you, and teach you what it means to be a follower of Jesus, what it means to live your life with a foundation on Christ. That being said, I am so proud of every one of you for making it through VBS 2020. I can't wait for VBS 2021. Hopefully we will be all together then. But for now, I will see you on Sunday. I love you guys, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.